Hello, I'm Steve Jones, and I'm going to tell you something about renewable resources. Now, renewable resources are not necessarily renewable energy, although it relates to energy. We have to be careful to distinguish between the two. Renewable resources, ores, plant material, biomass. Well, ores are not renewable. These are chemicals bound up in the ground. So these are not renewable. The reason they are not renewable is because they take years and years and years to make, in fact, millions of years. Oil, gas, coal, nuclear fuel, and all of the ores which are present in the Earth, usually within the structure of the Earth, are not really renewable. The renewable materials are basically plant materials and biomass. This can be anything coming from animals as well as from plant material. Now, if we want to use resources economically, what we have to do is look at those materials. If we've got ores and oil, gas, coal, nuclear fuel, these, we will not get them back. So we have to be economic, and we have to reduce waste. We have to recycle, and we have to reduce any energy usage, because these resources are basically burnt to produce energy. If we can reduce the amount of energy we use, we can reduce the rate at which these are used up on the Earth. So what do? We look at energy, and we look at sun, wind, wave, and tidal energy, and see where these can replace the energies that we are using produced from our fossil fuels and from our ores. If I make a bicycle, I have to melt the metal. That takes energy. I have to put it together. I have to create the rubber. That creates energy. Everything I make is using up energy. If I can reduce the amount of energy I use, I will save on these resources. And this is why in today's world we emphasize so much recycling, reducing of waste, and reduction of energy usage. So when you next think about throwing away your washing machine, make sure you throw it away in the right place where it can be recycled, so that we keep our renewable resources ready for the next generation.